Welcome back to Sunday Live. You're looking at live pictures there of Kijiji Village in Southland, Langata. This fire has been raging for more than an hour in that village. Looks like a couple of transformers there have exploded, and the inferno seems to be literally out of control. We're hearing stories that firefighters have arrived on the scene. If you're a believer in what you're reading on Twitter, it's saying they're arriving without water, but we cannot confirm that. We have in the studio live Nairobi Senator Sakaja Johnson. He's been talking to the local police chief, the local fire chief, the local rescuers, the first responders. And yes, we know the fire is literally raging in that village. People trying to salvage whatever they can. People yelling, screaming, calling for the governor, which is not necessary at this point because he'd be a big distraction, says the senator.
Governor, he is actually on top of it.
Yeah.
He's coordinating the fire guys, he's doing it himself.
Okay.
But he's also of the opinion that if he goes there, then it's another distraction. Because of security and these young guys who are there, we want, you know, to engage him on other issues. You know, so I think it's better he stays where he is, keeps on doing what he's doing. That's why we have structures. So the governor doesn't necessarily need to be there. But I'm sure he'll be one of the first people once it's settled. Because it must end, you know, it must end. There are a lot of gaps in disaster management in the country, and that's one of the things that, as the Senate Committee on National Security, where I'm the vice chair, we're really looking at. First of all, we have too many agencies that deal with disaster. We have National Disaster, and it's called NDOC. We have NDMA. We have one of the police, one of the military, etc. It is superfluous. I remember when the building went down in Huruma, and I was there for two nights. You know, a lot of the time they spent was deciding who's in charge of the operation, you know, instead of saving lives. And they do a lot, but we need a clear one center of coordination to be able to sort out these things and engage the people, use the people, let them be at the forefront. The first responders must be equipped to respond and to deal.
Yeah. When you see these kind of pictures, and like you were saying earlier on, or last month in December, there was another fire.
Yes.
I mean, is this frustrating for you as a, you know, a leader in this city, trying to get the city working? It's like one step forward, two, three steps backwards.
It is. It is. And my heart goes out to the families because it sets them back so badly. You know, the other day I took a lot of food to Madari, and they're saying, okay, you're giving us food, but we don't have stoves to cook the food. So when you have to go to a neighbor to ask them to cook for you, they take their commission, a percentage of the food you've given them, you know. And one of the areas we're going to exercise a lot of oversight on then is also the administration, because sometimes and I don't want to cast aspersions on their character, but sometimes they are beneficiaries of the congestion in these areas.
Yeah.
And so we want people who are as removed from the local, you know other interests that may play out, and are just there to work. Yeah. They're good men and women, but sometimes they might get distracted.
Yeah.
By the spoils, you know, this plot, that plot, and whatnot. Let's have professional management at the provincial administration level.
If this turns out to be a political thing, or some businessman wanting to grab some land or
we won't let it happen. We've seen it, and it's such a silly strategy.
Yeah.
It's the same thing that has happened in Gikomba.
Yeah.
Time over time.
Yeah.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
Because of a land dispute, you hear there's a fire, and you can even trace where it's coming from.
Yeah.
And somebody thinks that once the fire is quelled and the structures are down, they come and put a fence. It won't happen. They need to think of, let them do other business. Stop putting people's lives at risk because of your own financial interest. What joy will you have making money and going into a house that you know you've built based on the lives you've sacrificed, lives of people?
Literally, because there must be people burning in this.
Oh, no.
Must be people dead in this.
I sincerely hope.
Yeah, not. I fear. You know, I fear to think someone was sleeping, a family there, and you know, kids who are, you know, went early to bed because they're going to school tomorrow, and then this happened.
And the trauma lives on. People live their lives with that trauma,
yeah.
Especially young children. You know, they're so afraid of anything that looks close to a fire after that. And really, it breaks my heart. But anyway, that's why we're leaders. We need to make sure that this is not a story that keeps going on in Nairobi and all the informal settlements across the country, Jeff.
You know, it reminds me of when I was living in Lagos. And, yeah. You know, Lagos, a city of 20 million people.
Yeah.
Fires every week.
I know.
And then they elected a senator called Fashola.
Fashola.
Remember him?
I know him personally.
You do?
Yes. I know him personally. The time I was there, I was receiving an award, Changemaker Award for Africa, and I had the privilege to be able to interact with him and his people. His story is amazing,
yeah.
And his story really, you know, it vindicates what I say about leading a city like Nairobi, that you cannot try to be popular and run the city, you know, because you have to make tough decisions.
Yeah.
So for the first 3 years, people don't understand what you're doing. But in the fourth year, when they see the fruits of what you're doing, then they love you, you know. And that has always been my advice to my good friend, the governor. For us right now, it's our interest that our governor is able to perform and just to be focused on what needs to be done in this city.
Yeah.
Let people talk. You know, as a leader, never fear to be misunderstood. You know, the same way when I went to rescue, or rather bail out Babu, I knew there'd be a fight.
There'd be a fallout.
There'd be a fallout,
yeah.
You know, from hardliners and people who are still stuck in that kind of politics. But never be afraid to be misunderstood. If your conscience is clear and what you're doing is right, do it. They will understand later. People will understand later.
Speaking of your friend, the governor, yes. His deputy earlier this month shocked Kenyans when he resigned. There's no place in the constitution for resignation of a deputy governor.
There's none.
There's none.
There's none.
So he gave January 31st as the deadline where, you know, and he will be leaving. And you said you would step in and mediate some talks. What's the latest?
I've been able to speak to both of them and also other leaders in Nairobi. Number one, you know, as leaders, we must always realize that we get into these positions. It will not always be convenient or comfortable. If it's resigning, Jeff had resigned a long time ago, even as TNA chairman. Remember, I used to be fought every day.
Yes.
But, you know, you must remember the inspiration that got you into that office in the first place. It's about the people, you know.
Yeah.
And we must always remember, especially in our structure of governance, that it is the governor in whom executive power is vested, not the deputy governor. In fact, the deputy governor does what is assigned to him by the governor. So I think at some point, these promises used to make that, oh, Sonko atakuwa kwa ground, well, we run office, you know, it was campaign. You campaign in poetry, you govern in prose. and maybe, you know, so in as much as, and even the governor said it, that he'd have loved to continue working with Polycarp, but at the end of the day, it is to Polycarp's discretion. It is choice. If he doesn't want to serve, Nairobi will work. We are supporting our governor to be able to deliver. It's in everybody's interest. The Nairobi works, you know, or close to 60% of our country's GDP depends on the Nairobi that is working, you know. So we're giving the governor all the support he needs. In the Senate, we're looking at the law. Remember, even in the states, they have the same problem, and they have to pass the 25th Amendment,
correct,
on the Constitution to provide for absence of a deputy president, you know, or a vice president in the case of the U.S. So we're doing that, so that the governor can then choose somebody else, either from his cabinet or from from wherever, but that person then has to be subjected to, you know, the MCA's approval, because those are the people in whom the legislative authority in a county is vested in. It's a delegated responsibility from the residents of Nairobi to the MCA's, and then they can pass the person and we go on working. But there is no, and to assure Nairobians, there's no vacuum. We're working together as a team with the governor, with the women rep, with all the MPs, NASA and Jubilee, and all the MCA's, NASA and Jubilee. We've decided in Nairobi that the election is over, and that means then that let's focus on the interests of our people. And that's why when these stories came out and people were trying to, you know, castigate me and put me in a box that I've never been in, and I can never fit in, the people who came out to my defense are MCS from NASA and Jubilee. You know, like if in your county you're used to just one ethnicity and one way of doing things, not Nairobi. We all work together. We agree to disagree on some things, but we want to do it in a dignified way.
Yeah.
That's what the people of Nairobi care about, us being able to work. So Sonko must deliver, and we'll support him to deliver.
Absolutely, he must deliver, and it's not about delivering on Twitter where he sends a team to smoothen out one street in the CBD and say, we're smoothing out the city. That's not, you know, that's not what we want to see. And like you said, you know, don't be popular just to the whims of the people.
But you see, what you see on Zongo's Twitter is what he's doing on the ground. Our problems are huge in the city. I written to him a few weeks ago, asking him to give me the extent to which Nairobi is indebted in terms of national government institutions that owe us money in Nairobi. And he wrote back last week, and it's 65 billion shillings, you know, of rates, of certain charges that national government has all been paying Nairobi. So I'm trying to see within the Senate how, through conditional allocations, when we do the allocation of revenue to the counties, that money can be paid back. Remember, we've had a bloated public service in the city. Over the years, you know, people have come in and brought in their friends, their relatives and whatnot. And what that does then is a lot of the money that comes in Nairobi, close to a billion monthly salaries. You know, so 12 billion, and you're getting only 15 billion from the national government. I'm glad that the governor and his team have been able to streamline revenue collection, to automate it. The days of people walking out with bags of money from the cash office are over. You know, and people would say, no, a governor needs liquidity all the time as his governor. You know, that's theft, you know, and it must not go on. And we are looking at it. I mean, my work is to oversight that system that they have now, to see whether it is working for the people. And so once we raise the revenue, Nairobi can actually collect upwards of 100 million shillings even daily.
Every day?
Yes, it's possible.
Every day?
It's possible. If everyone who pays, pays. But how many of us who are talking about Nairobi not working, when you go park and it's supposed to be, you know, what 200, 300 shillings, you give the guy there 100 shillings to put in his pocket and you want services. The problems of Nairobi will be solved, first of all, if we sort out the issue of manners. It's manners, bad manners.
Bad manners.
The other day I was in traffic, and fortunately the car I was in that day is tinted. So I just watched. Next to me there was a matatu, and the driver went out, bought bananas. They ate those bananas, and they quickly, in quick succession, tossed those bananas up. So I lowered my window, and they were shocked. I told them, now you will throw those bananas on the road, and then you say, Sonko has failed to clean the city. Yourselves. A machine on a kazi. But you're the ones doing it. Look at this intersection just up the road at Yaya.
But hold on, hold on. Were they shocked?
They were shocked. They had to get out of their vehicles and pick up
no.
the pills. Yes, and I told them, create a dustbin. Put a dustbin in that matatu.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. So that anybody who tosses out a bottle, whatnot, tell them no.
Look up.
Here's Yungwana. I like what I saw Ken the other day.
Yeah.
Here's Ushenzi.
Ushenzi.
You know, look at our intersections. Just simple intersections.
Yes.
Focus, cause a traffic stall-up. Because we cannot give way to the next person. So we are competitive to a fault, we are thinking about ourselves, and we want Nairobi to work. 60% of our problems will be solved by good manners. These fires you will not see if we realize that actually there's a rule of law in the city. And the first people to follow the rule of law must be the leaders. We must set a good example to the people of Nairobi.
Absolutely. I'm going to read a couple of tweets if I can. Monica, I'll go to yours in a second, but there's your good friend Kabando wa Kabando.
KK.
KK, he says, my friend Sakaja Johnson is patriotic, brilliant achiever legislator.
Thank you.
He needs to carefully blend ambition with dynamics of city real politic. That is empathy, sympathy with backyard.
That's interesting. That's a lot. I think I need to buy him coffee to get more clarity on what he's talking about. But it's true. I mean, it's a balance. I mean, you do something, you lose some support, you win some support.
Yeah.
But Jeff, if everything we do is with the focus of what votes am I getting and what am I losing, then you will not deliver as a leader.
Yeah.
You won't be able to.
There's a question from Ahmed Asmali from Eastleigh saying, we have 17 counties in constituencies. Yeah.
Yeah.
Constituencies in Nairobi.
Yes.
Why don't we have 17 fire engines in those 17 constituencies?
You see, and that's a good question, because we have received a lot of fire engines. They need to be spread out, but the infrastructure that supports disaster management must also be in place. You need fire engines in a place where they can easily be able to get water and get access into those places. But number two, and this is something that I'm really asking my governor and other governors in the governor of Kisumu and Mombasa. Is look at the Urban Areas and Cities Act and try and implement it. It provides for an extra layer of devolution where you have city managers. You know, like Nairobi, you for you to run Nairobi well, you need to at least devolve it to at least four barrows, so to speak, mm-hmm. and have the exact replica of your departments in those areas, you know, so that your four city managers, or you know, something similar, who are the central point for delivery of services. So with garbage, I know in Nairobi North, there's a person who's dealing with it, there's a person responsible, and once you've given people the tools to perform, if I drive in Westlands or in Kayole and I see a garbage dump, you're fired.
Straight.
Yeah. You go out. Yeah. That's the only way you'll be able to do it. But you see now, you know, if you're so high up, that then you cannot trace responsibility, there's no trail of responsibility, then you'll not be able to manage. This is a city of 5 million people.
Yeah. And counting.
And counting.
Nyar Gero says Sakaja Johnson is a true leader. He doesn't play party politics. He is human first.
thank you.
Fred Obach Machoka. man in Black Africa says, Jeff, kindly ask Honorable Sakaja why Nairobi can't have a master plan to be implemented in phases instead of each successive governor coming with their own. Alfred Mutua, Stones, Kidero, Grass, Sonko. We don't know yet.
Jeff, we don't have a shortage of plans.
Yeah.
You know, like one of the best plans that we have is the urban mass transit system that was done so many years ago by JICA, you know, in conjunction with the Metropolitan Ministry. I remember Professor, what's his name, was a PS of the Metropolitan, was the, I remember his name. Karega Mutahi, mm-hmm. and all that, and it's a beautiful plan, you know. There's an urban renewal plan that was started in the last government, that the governor of Nairobi now is implementing it. So it's not about the plans, really. It's about implementation of these plans and just having the, let me look for a good word, things on TV.
the cojones?
The guts.
Yes.
You know, just to say, you know what? I'm doing this, nafunga macho, and I'm doing this. I'll implement it, and I only want to be governor for one time, and this is what I'm going to do. And by the way, people will say, "Sonko tena," you know?
Yeah.
Because our governor has a heart for the people.
Yes.
Yeah. And he needs them to translate that. And I'm glad that I'm seeing now. You know, he's getting his chief officers in line, his county executive committee. He just needs to close his eyes and say, "This is what we're doing. We're implementing it."
Absolutely.
We have confidence in him. A lot of Nairobians have confidence in him. He got close to 1 million votes.
He did?
Yeah, so did I and Esther. But his was to govern the city.
Yeah.
And his votes were also across political divide.
They were. More tweets. Kiage Kevin says, Senator Sakaja gives the youth a larger picture of politics and leadership as it should be.
Thank you, Kevin.
And Jehia Kelvin, you say, good evening, Jeff. Kindly tell Sakaja Johnson to stop being too good and also too friendly to everyone.
That's interesting advice. He wants me to be a bit bad and less friendly. Jeff,
yeah.
Politics should never change a character of a man.
Yeah.
Just remain who you are. And that's who I am.
But okay, so you're a nice guy by nature. Is that what you're saying?
I have my shortcomings. There are people who think I'm the devil. So, you know?
All right. Back to this fire, by the way, Senator. I got a message here from Mama Kenovia. And she says, how come there's no fire brigade going to this huge fire in Langata? Even Langata military camp is just next door, just nearby.
You know, Jeff, that's what I'm talking about, you know, a multi-agency coordination between all this and NDOC, NDMA, whatnot. Because sometimes you have the tools close, but the chain of command, the bureaucracy is too much. You cannot do it. I'll give the example again of Uruma. That time, even to get, you know, diesel for the generators, I had to buy from my own pocket. And the military and NYS, you know, they have a huge workshop just next to, you know, Madare.
Yeah.
They're not able to do it. So these are some of the things that we're saying must be done. You might have the best intentions, but sometimes bureaucracy will prevent you from doing that. So it's a sad situation. Let it be something that happens and we come and talk about it on TV and then it's done. Then the next thing happens and we say the same thing.
Exactly. We keep repeating ourselves.
We keep repeating ourselves.
It's ridiculous.
Too much.
Jaro Soja. You know him?
Yes, I was with him today in Nakuru.
In Nakuru, Abraha.
He has a motorbike, my friend.
What?
Oh, you should see that photo.
Jaro Soja.
Top deadly one.
God, Maria 001, he says.
Just tell Superintendent Sakaja to keep on supporting football. Yeah. We are proud of him.
Asante.
Mercy Kiplamai. Mm-hmm. She works security, actually, okay. Royal Media. This is my Super Senator Sakaja Mweshimiwa. You showed no tribe or political affiliation with Honorable Babu Owino. Cheers. Praise. You are doing well, enjoying the show at home.
Asante.
Excellent, excellent. Okay, look, what do you want to do, Monica? Should we continue on, or... Because there's so many tweets coming thick and fast.
Yeah.
Your friend Monica is directing tonight.
Yes. And that she does an amazing job.
Oh, she does.
She does an amazing, amazing job.
She does. Yeah. We're just here looking good because of them, you know.
Yeah.
That's why I keep shouting her name, just in case.
Asante Monica.
Mohammed Waliye, all the way from Jeddah, Saudi Arabia.
One of the most brilliant minds we have.
Isn't he?
One of the...